In the name of our fathers, our children and generations unborn, let it be known and let it be on record that there were people in Eastern Region Biafra who were shouting at the top of their voices that the Hausa Fulani Yoruba oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate have colonized the Anang, Esik, Ibibi, Igbo, Ijo, Ugoja, Ishekiri, Ishan, Isoko, and Urobo. That all the people living within the geographical area extending from Warisapele in the west to Calabar Ikoma Ugoja in the east, and from Opobobone in the south to Enugu Ezike Ikem in the north, have been enslaved. That their land, mineral resources in their land, as well as water resources in their territory, have been seized by these oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate. That these oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate are exploiting the mineral and other resources in this land and selling them, and currently have realized trillions of dollars from the sales. That these oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate are using the money thus realized to build financial empires for themselves and using whatever is left to develop cities and towns in Yoruba land in western Nigeria and Hausa Fulani and other land in northern Nigeria. Let it be on record that as the Hausa Fulani Yoruba were doing this, Biafra Foundation, Biafra Government in Exile, and other pro-Biafran organizations were shouting at the top of their lungs that the Hausa Fulani Yoruba oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate are carrying out a campaign of total enslavement of our people, seizure of our land, mineral and water resources, destruction of our culture, our values, our beliefs, our philosophy of life, and wholesale slaughter of our people, including young men and women, old men and women, and children. That this is genocide, willful destruction of generations of our people, cataclysmic tragedy of unimaginable proportion, being visited on our people by the Hausa Fulani Yoruba oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate. We want it to be on record that as this genocide was taking place, and that as we were screaming about it, most of our elders, political leaders, religious leaders, intellectuals, traditional leaders, high-ranking military leaders, heads of civic societies, big business entrepreneurs, etc., kept mum, pretended that they did not see that our socio-political and cultural house has been literally set ablaze by the Hausa Fulani Yoruba oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate, and that we were in danger of being consumed by this conflagration. It is now 2 weeks since the Hausa Fulani Yoruba Nigerian Army, Air Force and Navy declared total war on the civilian population of the Eastern Region Biafra. They have been using all the sophisticated weapons of modern warfare, which they bought with the trillions of dollars they realized from the sale of land and mineral resources belonging to our people. They have been using jet bombers and fighters to bomb villages and towns in Eastern Region Biafra. They have been using helicopter gunships to shoot and kill innocent men, women, and children at close range from the air. They have been using warships to indiscriminately shell towns and villages and slaughter our innocent men, women, and children. They have unleashed the Hausa Fulani Yoruba Army of Nigeria to march into our towns and villages and kill innocent men, women, and children. Pillage, rape, and burn down entire towns and villages methodically and systematically. The Hausa Fulani Yoruba Nigerian Army has been destroying and burning down our towns, one town after another, from Azama, Kunukunam, Krutia, Okerenkeko, Oporozua, Benikurukuru, Okronanko, Kolidegbe, Baramutu, as well as occupying Kiama, Odi, Opokuma, Yenegua, Bomadi, Patani, Okrika, Degema, Boni, Buguma, Abonima, Obibo, Elele, Ekom, Umumasi, Ikwere, and other towns. If you look carefully at the map, you will immediately see that the military objective of the Hausa Fulani Yoruba oligarchs and the Sokoto Caliphate is to surround the entire eastern region Biafra, put a noose around our neck, and choke off any life left in the people of eastern region Biafra. This military objective is simple. Put a noose around the neck of eastern region Biafra, tighten the noose and choke off the air supply to this region and let it die slow death. The Hausa Fulani control our northern borders. The Yoruba control our western borders. The only outlet we have is our southern and eastern borders. Once they shut off the eastern and southern borders, they can easily blockade, lay siege on the eastern region Biafra, and put a chokehold on it until it dies. Until it dies economically, politically, culturally, and socially. That is the scenario you are looking at right now. Anyone from the eastern region Biafra who does not see this is not looking carefully or is simply naive. It is not hard to see that this is the gravest danger any people can face in the world today. To allow anyone to put a military noose around your neck is nothing short of self-immolation or suicide. The Jews experienced it in Europe under the Nazi, and 6 million of them were slaughtered by Hitler, a price too dear to pay for slavish obedience and failure to resist the earliest signs of tyranny and genocide. The Jews learned their bitter lesson and vowed that it will never happen to them ever again. They learned that if you are weak, subservient, and beggarly, you will be exploited, dehumanized, and killed by the strong. The world may watch with disgust, but they may never come to your aid. It is your responsibility to defend yourself, to stand up against oppression, tyranny, and genocide. If you don't, nobody else will. If you complain against oppression, tyranny, and genocide, nobody will pay attention to you. If you beg for your freedom, your rights, and your liberty, you will never get them. If you beg your oppressor, enslaver, or genocidist, they will not pay attention to you. In fact, they become more savage in their perpetration of slavery and genocide. Your only option is to fight back. Separate yourself from your oppressor, enslaver, and genocidist, and declare your freedom and independence.